Hey YouTube. So I wanted to do sort of a review of a gaming console thing. This is not something I normally do on my channel. Usually my channel is very political. I'm not a gamer. I really don't care about video games too much, though I do play occasionally. But it's not a big part of what I do for entertainment and stuff. But I do love me some retro gaming. I already went through and built myself a little RetroPie system here, and it's pretty fun. The kind of controllers that I can use for this thing, it's really easy to set up, is like this, or this is another one that I have, a little cheap Chinese piece of crap, but it works great, and everything. But the problem is, if you're going to emulate something like, if you're going to emulate something like the Atari 5200, or if you're going to emulate something like a television, or the Colecovision, it's extremely hard to kind of configure these controllers because you have to configure it for every single game, because the controllers kind of have like this thing where it's a bunch of there's like a keypad, little action buttons on the side, a directional disc, and a lot of those games you kind of have to configure those kind of controllers for like every single game, and it's a hassle. But good news is, AtGames had released a version of one of their AtGames Flashback things for a variety of systems, mostly the Atari. However, they did do the Atari or 2600. They also have done, I believe, the 7200, Sega Genesis, ColecoVision, and the Intellivision. Now, Intellivision is the system that I grew up with. A lot of my friends either grew up with the Atari or waited until the NES came out, but me, both of my grandparents had an Intellivision, and so I grew up around that. That was my first gaming console. And to this day, I find them very fun, but it's really hard to emulate with those kinds of controllers. So, AtGames released this thing, and they reproduced the controllers, spot on. One difference that they did is actually an improvement, and that's these little side buttons. They're a lot less clicky and embedded. They're actually a little bit more out and squishy, and it's a lot easier on the fingers. Overall, it's pretty much like playing on the original thing with that one little improvement, which is great. I love these controllers actually better than the hardware. Now, I've always wanted to kind of get back into playing these games, and I didn't want to go down the collector route because that can get very expensive, because some of these games are super rare and super expensive. And then, or if I wanted to get something like a multi-card or a kettle card or one of those flash cart things where you can put all your games in just one card, even those can be kind of expensive. So I could either go down the hardware route or get this thing. So I got this thing at a little event that we do here in Vegas for the Liberty on the Rocks thing. During the Christmas, we just started doing a capitalismus where we all buy ourselves a gift. And, instead of giving gifts, we buy ourselves one. And I decided to buy one of this because I saw this on Amazon, and I was like, oh, that's neat. So I got one, and then I was kind of playing with it, and I was like, I wonder if this thing could be hacked so I can put some of the other ROMs on there, because it comes with 60 games, and a lot of the really good games that I loved playing as a kid aren't on this thing. A lot of them are, but most of them aren't. And I was like, I wonder if this could be hacked to play like other games. And so I started looking into it, and it seems like the only thing that people could figure out, at least on Atari age, was, why don't we just gut the thing out, put a RetroPie in there, and make it an emulation thing. But tried to finally get this ultimate PC thing to work with the RetroPie so that you can emulate these controllers on there. And they did. And after they got done, they had like this mess of a thread where they're all kind of going through step by step trying to figure this stuff out. And they ended up figuring it out. You can go through this thing yourself, pay $120 to get all the pieces and everything to put it together yourself. Or you can go through a service called the Ultimate Intellivision Flashback Upgrade Service, which is provided by one of the users at Atari Age. You send him $149, ship him out your flashback, and he will turn it into this. This is what I got. And what he does is he puts a retro, if you look inside there, there is a Raspberry Pi 3 in there. What you can't see in there, maybe you can kind of see something in there, but He also puts the Ultimate PC adapter in there. I don't know what exactly it's called, but it's an adapter that converts the Colecovision, Sega Genesis controllers, and Intellivision controllers to USB, so you can do it. They got that, got the configure out. They also have like this custom version of RetroPie, which I'll show you later. And then he puts the 60 games that come on the Intellivision Flashback on there, as well as a couple of homebrew games. Now, I've also kind of already threw on every other game that was on the system as well through the ROM system, which is, you can either use the USB stick, and it also has Wi-Fi enabled. Still kind of working on adding some of the box art, but I got a lot, most of them done anyway, so I got a lot more work to do. But I think this service is well recommended. I'm going to kind of show you the system, what it does, what it looks like, what you can expect, but one of the things I wanted to talk about as far as the hardware goes, when you first buy these at-game things, it feels like there's maybe, if you're lucky, like a piece of paper in there. It is so light. But now this really has some heft. You can feel like, oh yeah, there's definitely something in there. That's one thing. The other thing is on the website, some of the manuals are outdated. Like, it still says they're using a Raspberry Pi 2. They're not. They're using a Raspberry Pi 3. They say that the reset button doesn't work. You just use the power button or one of the controls on the controller. You get a little combination control to get it to reset. However, I found the reset button does work, and I'll show you that later. The power button still works. The little LED light still works. I mean, this guy really put some effort into figuring out how to get this thing working and working well. So I'm going to turn this around, get my other camera, aim it at the TV, and show you what it looks like and what it can do. Worms. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started. We'll start fire this thing up. And I kind of show you some of the stuff that it can do. So, if right off the bat you'll notice that all those kind of things that they show with the Raspberry Pi are gone. There's no start boot text or anything like that. So everything's really clean and nice. That start screen is a whole lot better than what I was seeing in a lot of the other reviews. And if you also notice that if we go hit left or right at the main thing, there's no menu or anything like that because everything's streamlined. It's already set, ready to go. It's all you needed to do. It's just playing television, right? So to get into it, you're gonna hit the top fire button. Actually hit it. And as you can see, I already have most of the games on here. I don't have all the box art. And you know I'm just dying to get the backgammon box art ready to go for this thing. But I got most of it on there. So let's play this. It's a classic. It's a classic. Everything sounds great. Everything looks great. Everything is responsive. Now, let's say that you just died right there and you want to get back to the, try again, fresh start. What you would hit is the 5 and 0 button, and you're taken back to the main title of the game, so you can go right back and do playing all over again. Or you could go back to the game select stage by hitting 6 and enter. That'll take you back to the main game select screen. So you want to play a game like Burger Time? There you go. Everything still looks and sounds great. Let's pepper this guy to give you an idea of what it sounds like. There was a big problem with this thing, the original system, the Flashback, out of the box, with a buzzing sound and some of the other audio emulation, which seems to have been fixed. Night Stalker is a good example of one I know I can get a buzz out of. Especially with the buzzing sound, I guess the buzzing sound, they did not emulate that thing well at all. This one does sound great. As you can see, responds well, plays well, sounds as it should, including when you die. Oh, that sound, that notable sound. So we're gonna go back to the main screen again. And, yeah. So, a couple other things. Right out of the gate, your TV is going to want to force the that sort of kind of aspect ratio. I found this to be a little bit hard to deal with because when you're moving left and right, it's not the same as moving up and down because it's stretching it out wide. So you seem to move faster when you go up and down versus left and right, and it kind of throws off your game a little bit, at least for me. So what I did is I just turned the aspect ratio to one where I can get one that looks like 4:3. That seems to be eliminated, though the box art's a little bit stretched, but well worth it. The other thing I've noticed with this thing, and I'm sure it'll probably be fixed now that I mentioned it, but mine does not do the 2 and 8. When you do this, allegedly skips you up 10 games or so. This doesn't work. However, when you're dealing with a system that only has 125 games and a handful of, well, maybe not a handful. I only have a handful of homebrews. It's not a big deal. I mean, as you can see, I'm already on S, and by the time I finish this sentence, I'm already, like, at the very top. So, I mean, it doesn't really take that long to kind of scroll through the system. There's not that many games. Even if you were to port all of the homebrews on this thing, still, it's not going to be well enough where you're really going to need that anyway. It would have been a convenience, but I really don't care. All things said and done, like, everything else is so great about this thing, is perfect. Sound emulation is perfect. The video emulation is better than perfect because you're actually playing it on HDMI versus AV out or coaxial. The sound, everything sounds great. Everything is really responsive. The controllers are spot on and a little bit improved as well. This is probably one of the best things I've ever done. Now, if you were to go and try to find some of these hardwares, for example, I know my favorite game on this system, which is Thunder Castle, is one of the most rarest games you can find. One of the more rare ones. There's ones far more rare. This one will probably end up costing you $200 alone if you find them on eBay, if I recall correctly. At least that's what I've been told. But it's one of the best games on the system. My grandparent had it, and I used to play this thing religiously. But, you know, now it's really hard to find. And just this alone is worth just as much as getting one of these things. So if you want some information on how to do this, I'm going to post a link below to the Amazon link. That'll take you to the to an Amazon page where you can purchase the Flashback. And I'll also link you to the service page as well as the thread where they're going through and trying to figure out how to get this thing to work. So if you want to do it yourself, you can do it that way. You know, your choice is yours. Yeah, I can't recommend this service enough. If you're into the ColecoVision, he also has an upgrade service for the ColecoVision Flashback. So if you want to do that as well, I'll post links to all this too. you can do that as well as the Atari 2600. He may do more. I don't know. It seems like those are the ones that he's doing: the Intellivision Flashback, the ColecoVision Flashback, and the Atari 2600 Flashback. He also has upgrade services for all those. He also installs a Raspberry Pi in all those. Makes it look pretty like all of these, except it's not going to have the Intellivision theme for the ColecoVision or the Atari. It's going to have their own, and they also look really great. I don't see a point of getting a ColecoVision because they're mostly arcade ports anyway. There's a MAME emulator for that. But if that's what you grew up on and you want some little bit of nostalgia for it, it's there. And ColecoVision's also one of those consoles that still has a fairly active homebrew community. So if you're into that, as well as the Atari 2600. But the games that are coming out for the Intellivision today are really, really fantastic. So, can't recommend this enough. Byte Knight, you got a wonderful service there. Can't recommend it enough. And till next time, worms.